Hi everyone, welcome to Outdoor Bound TV. I'm Kurt Walbeck. For well over two decades, the state of Wisconsin has held a separate 9-day gun deer season for individuals that hold a specific disabled permit in that state. The hunt takes place in early October, when the lack of snow and warmer temperatures makes it much easier for individuals with disabilities. The Hess family, along with some of their associates of Wisconsin-based Badger Mining Corporation, have been hosting hunters on many of their properties for what is now their 20th season. One of these hunters, Kyle Camp, a Berlin, Wisconsin native, and we're lucky enough to follow along with him on this early fall hunt. So let's head to the small western Wisconsin town of Taylor right now.
Hi, I'm Kyle Camp, and I'm from Berlin, Wisconsin, and I'm here in, it's in Taylor, Wisconsin, with Tom Gagno, and we're out in a picked cornfield, just waiting to get the badger gun hunting started out for the October disabled deer season. Today it's pretty nice outside actually. The forecast was for rainy weather, but it's probably in the upper 50s, low 60s, and it sure is great conditions to get out and hopefully snag a shoot a big buck. I have cerebral spinal ataxia, and I was born with it. It's actually recessive disorder, and it primarily affects my ability to use my legs, and my balance is affected, and it's a little harder to get around, but it's an obstacle for me. I try my best and work out and walk and just try to be the best person I can be. I grew up in Berlin, Wisconsin, and I went to Berlin High School, graduated in 2002, and then went on to college at St. John's University in Collegeville, Minnesota, where I majored in communication and took some econ financing, and other financial courses. And presently, I work at Farmers and Merchants Bank in Berlin, Wisconsin. Presently, I'm in the loan operations department, helping out with loan documents and paperwork, checking through scans to make sure everything's up to date and in the system. This hunt that I'm on right now, Badger Mining, puts on a hunt every year for people with disabilities and handicaps, so they are able to get outside and enjoy the outdoors, even with their limitations. All of the employees at Badger Mining, they all try to participate and help out. So all of us, all of the applicants like me, can go out and enjoy the outdoors and shoot does and bucks and enjoy the outdoors.
Mississippi River bluegill.
Yeah, it's so good. Andy does a great job. It's good stuff.
Yeah, I'm getting there, Kyle.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Mission Crossbows and HHA Sports.
My name is Matt Hess. I work for Badger Mining Corporation. I actually work in the engineering department and also one of the family members that own the company. So, Badger Mining's based out of Berlin, Wisconsin. We're an industrial sand mining company, a family-owned business. And the three locations in Wisconsin are our St. Marie property, which is used to be a mining operation but has since been reclaimed and is essentially recreational land now. And then Fairwater Plant, which is primarily a foundry sand business that supplies the valley with foundry sands for castings. And then the third property is Taylor, where we're here today. And that primarily, that mining operation is primarily for the oil and gas industry, supplying frac sand for the oil wells and gas wells. The outdoors is really near and dear to our whole family, so we love it. We know other people that enjoy it just as much. And so, you know, with the operations, with the mining operation, we have, you know, we try to maintain a buffer around the properties. So that allows us to, you know, accumulate a certain amount of land mass that allows a pretty significant management program. And so for us, you know, God gave us the opportunity to look over this property, and it's really rewarding to get people in here that don't have the opportunity to experience that. So that's probably our primary goal, is to really be good stewards of the land, right? That stems from agricultural practices, the timber practices, and creates a nice wildlife habitat, which would allow, you know, a great hunting experience for these individuals. Actually, this year starts marks the 20th anniversary of the disability hunt for Badger. We started sponsoring the hunt with an associate of ours by the name of Bob Bartle, who was an avid outdoorsman, but somewhere along the line he suffered a neck injury and was confined to a wheelchair as a quadriplegic. And a few other associates in the company, you know, knowing Bob, he was avid outdoorsman, but just didn't get the opportunity to go out anymore. And so they took it upon themselves to get signed up for the disability hunt and sponsored the first hunt with Bob. And you know, through those first years, it was a little bit of trial and tribulation, but managed to have some success with him. And from that point, we just started to add a few more individuals to the hunt. And now today we have three different properties. You know, this hunt really brings everybody together. We've got individuals cooking meals, you know, cleaning up the place afterwards. We've got people cleaning deer. It really just draws out the best in people. And that's probably one of the most rewarding parts of it, you know, to see the smile on people's faces, whether it's our own associates or the hunters themselves. You know, it's truly just a really rewarding experience. We actually started this hunt here at Taylor with Kyle. He was our first hunter, and you know, at that point in time, we probably had four or five different locations that we could get to with a wheelchair and to allow a good quality hunt. And since then, we've probably progressed to, I would say, 20 or 25 different locations, which allows us to play the wind and do all the normal things you would hunting. And again, just really, really maximizing the opportunity for these individuals.
not sure. I think I hit him, but I was kind of shaky.
He didn't jump up and kick.
Yeah, I saw him. Well, I tried to put it right on his shoulder, and I'm not sure. I was kind of a little shaky, so I'm not sure if I...
Going that way.
Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Take 11.
Yep, 11 pointer. So, geez, that's a dandy. I never, biggest one I ever shot was a 8 pointer. I think a few years ago here with these guys too. So I'm so thankful to Matt and Tom and everyone here at Badger for giving me these great opportunities to hunt. So thanks, guys.
When we see individuals harvest maybe their first deer or their largest deer, that, you know, I don't know if words, we can really put it into words how gratifying that is. It's, again, you have your own ability, and many of these individuals don't have all their physical abilities. I mean, most of them are sharper than I am, but, and I think that's really what one of the things we want to strive to do is kind of take them away from that challenge that they have physically and make them forget it, you know, even if it's only for a short time. There's been a number of people that have actually touched my life. You know, some of the things they've said has really made me look at myself, and you know, they may approach issues with such a smile on their face, and that really keeps you going. So I hope it's a reciprocity where we keep them going and they in turn keep us going as well.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Rapala and Mountain Dew.
You know what's really special? When individuals come together to help make a difference in other people's lives without ever expecting anything in return. To the staff at Badger Mining Corporation, thank you for being some of those individuals. Now, do you know of someone that has a disabled permit and would be interested in taking part in this special hunt? There's a website on the screen. I'd encourage you to have them log on and apply, because I know the staff at Badger Mining Corporation would love to host them on a future hunt. And we hope that you'll join us again here next week when we'll bring you more great hunting and fishing action from around the US, around Canada, and around the world, right here on Outdoor Bound TV.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Matthews Archery and Vortex Optics.
I'm losing it here for a second.
No, that's fine. Couldn't you start over again? Just... I forgot for the bullets were. Oh, that's a bad thing.